everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. You might think the games get more important as we get deeper into the season. Try selling that to this sellout crowd who's been screaming their guts out and ready for kickoff in the SEC. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brett Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
For another college football brouhaha. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Louisiana Lafayette has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. Taken at the 5. They'll bring him down at the 28. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Pitch out, got the corner. They'll bring him down right around the 38-yard line. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. Room around the corner. And he shoved out of bounds at the 47.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play-action pass.
The stop at the 44-yard line.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
Second and 13. Ball on the 44-yard line. He's still going. He's tackled at the 47-yard line. Zips it over the middle. And he's taken down around the 17-yard line.
Hey, watching that quarterback make that play, that is a big-time throw. I thought he did a nice job with his vision. Looking under the defense, really just trying to survey the defense to see where he needs to make the throw. And he waited until the last second, but he made the right throw. He put it in position again for that receiver to make that play.
He's taken down at about the 7-yard line. This is the 8th play of this drive. And now he pitches it. He gets out to about the 6-yard line. Made right around the 6-yard line.
You keep gaining negative yards and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. Arkansas is looking to go up by three. Kicks away, and he got it.
A quick update now. Here's Reese.
The Little Apple is rocking as Kansas State is ready to go. The Tigers light the scoreboard first with a rushing touchdown. The Tigers lead 7-0.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out. That's a D-1.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled at the 41. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. And that one's incomplete.
There was just no way anybody could catch up with that pass.
Price, back to return it. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Arkansas is up by three. Down at about the 35.
The option is all about timing, and on that play, the timing was just off. That's going to happen sometimes.
From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. He might have a chance. He's at the 40. Tackle at the 26-yard line. And he busted that one wide open.
On defense, you can't afford to give up big runs like that.
He laterals the ball. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Tackles him hard at the 21-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. Third down.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Larry. Hey, Mike 20. Here we go.
After one quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. 3-0, Arkansas. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. Arkansas has a 3-point lead.
Ready.
He's tackled in the open field.
The offense only got the first down by about a yard, but I'm sure they'll be happy with a new set of downs.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really is nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
He might have a chance. Gains his way to the 10-yard line. He makes the PAT. Here's an update from the studio in Reese Davis.
Arkansas State in action in Jonesboro. The Red Wolves keep pounding away on the ground and they find pay dirt. Arkansas State leads it 14-10.
I don't expect that score is going to hold, but boy, that would be an upset. They line up to kick this one away. From his own goal line. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 27. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's under some heat. They'll make the sack. Raging Cajuns have one of the most dangerous offensive weapons in the entire country under center today. This kid is really fun to watch. He's fun to watch unless you're a defensive coordinator. One thing's for sure, it's going to be a great chess match between the offensive and defensive coordinators today. So it'll be second and 14 after the setback. And he's tackled right away.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
There he goes. Makes it out to about the 50.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
And what's that? And what's the ball? 86 to me. 86 to me.
Gets some open field. Makes it to the 37.
First down.
Makes it to the 24.
Now he took the pitch there and was able to get the first down. It's a nice option play.
Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
That's good for a gain of 20 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Raging Cajuns. Here's the point after to try to cut this to a three-point game. And he adds the extra point. So a seven-play, 74-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. The score now, 10-7. Louisiana Lafayette is lining up to kick this one off. Price fields it at the 9, and he's tackled at the 25-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Arkansas holds a field goal lead.
That's a gain of 1 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 9.
Second.
He's to the 40. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. Makes it out to about the 39.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. From the 39-yard line. First down. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
Runs outside for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and 2.
Roger. Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
Easy. Gets out to around the 22.
Boy, that was a rocket. If the receiver didn't come down with it, the quarterback made sure nobody else was going to come down with it either.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Arkansas is up a field goal. He scrambled. They'll bring him down right around the 20. So it's 4th down, and the offense is still on the field. The Razorbacks quarterback went down with that injury that you saw earlier. We don't want to speculate, but he's in the locker room, and it doesn't look good. Looks to the back and can't connect.
Well, they decided to go for it, but the defense slammed the door on him. That's the definition of coming through when it matters most. It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
He's got it out to his tight end, and he's level at the 39-yard line. Tries to buy some time, and he dives forward. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He's at the 30, and they finally push him out at the 23.
First and 10.
From the 23-yard line, it's first down.
Three down.
Let's go.
319.
And a quick throw. And they make the stop at about the 19-yard line. Taylor picks up about 4 yards with the catch. The Raging Cajuns will use their first time out of the half. Hart takes a handoff. He gets out to about the 18-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. The Raging Cajuns use their second time out. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He's tackled around the 7-yard line.
Check.
That makes it first and goal.
Snake eyes.
He's on the run. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown.
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 26.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Scrambling around. He gets sacked on the play.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you're definitely going to feel it the next day.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. And he's taken down at the 34-yard line. We've played a half of football. Louisiana Lafayette leads 14-10.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. I'm a fan of seeing guys one step wrap, two step squeeze, bring your feet, arrive with bad intentions. I don't want to take anything away from these defensive guys, David, but could this be that we're seeing a healthy dose of some pretty bad offense too?
It goes hand in hand, doesn't it, Reese?
Sometimes
you know, pretty good defense makes, you know, average offenses look really, really bad. But you know, when you have a great defense and you can take something away, especially the strength of the other offense, and make them do things that they don't do exceptionally well, and, you know, don't let them throw the fastball, make them throw the curve. I mean, you see great defenses be able to do that all the time, and that's when you can be ultra successful. You have to find ways to make people play, you know, the game out of their comfort zone.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 29.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold?
Louisiana Lafayette is up four. Caught with room to work. He's knocked out of bounds.
Right around the 38-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Three down. Hit the tees and Mike. Watch Mike. Ready.
Tackle made at the 35-yard line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. He makes the catch and has a first down. He's taken down
right around the 44-yard line.
Too easy.
First down.
Mike 40. Let's go.
Nice run up the middle.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That brings up second and 5.
Around the 48-yard line. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Under pressure, and they got him.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Louisiana Lafayette holds a 4-point lead. He gets out to about the 35-yard line.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
It falls incomplete. From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. Brought down at the 34. They'll lose a yard on that quarterback keeper. Here comes the pressure. He goes downtown. Can't connect.
Young intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Harvey, the return man. Brought down at the 35. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. Here they come. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Dives for extra yardage. Louisiana Lafayette is up by 4. He's scrambling. Run right, hit in the backfield.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. He airs it out. Found his man. Tackle at about the 7-yard line.
Thomas on the tackle at the 7-yard line.
Man left.
That makes it first and goal.
He is drilled at the 9. It's second and goal. Ball on the 9-yard line.
Yeah.
finds his receiver. Touchdown.
Tremendous example of the type of chemistry that these two players enjoy. When a quarterback and a receiver are on the same page, good things tend to happen.
And he tacks on the extra point. So that's a six-play, 64-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 24. The Raging Cajuns continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
Makes it second and six.
Larry, check 59. Mike is 59.
Easy. And he's tackled at about the 37-yard line. In and he's got a lane. Makes it out to about the 50. They'll get him for a loss.
Loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Second and 13. Ball on their own 47.
Here we go, here we go. Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Throws it deep. It's complete. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. Score here early in the fourth quarter, but they've got to get their heads back in it now. We've got a tight football game and a long way to go.
They'll go for two in this situation.
Defense stacked in tight here.
He's got the two.
Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Let's take a look at scores around the country. This is a game we've been watching closely all day long. And for Kansas State, they're in danger of losing two straight. The Tigers lead it by 7 early in the fourth quarter.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here.
Looks like they're ready for the kick.
He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Question now in a one-possession game, can they make it a two-possession game? They've got a chance to put this thing out of reach. Louisiana Lafayette has a 3-point lead. He's under pressure.
He goes out of bounds
around the 28-yard line. Throws it in a hurry.
They'll bring him down
around the 43-yard line.
Gaining 15 yards. First down.
Makes it to the 47.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And they make the stop
around the 45-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Now he's scrambling. He's tackled at the 36.
That's a good game. That brings up second and 1.
He scrambled. Decides to slide.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. And he's taken down
around the 14-yard line.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
Touchdown, Ragin' Cajuns.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
And he adds the extra point.
So an 8-play, 76-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Foster
has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep.
Price takes it from the 6. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 36-yard line.
Boy, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out on the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
We're about set to start things up again.
To buy some time. They'll make the sack.
No gain on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
Check 82. Watch 82. Ball's coming 82. Hey, here we go.
He's on the run. He's at midfield. And he's level at the 49.
Just under 3 to go in regulation.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Throws to the right to his fullback. Tackle made
at about the 39-yard line.
He's going to try and scramble. He's taken down at the 38-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
Scrambling around, and down he goes at the 34-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on one play. That'll make it 35.
Hey, number 8's coming. Number 8's Mike. Come on.
receiver, and it falls incomplete. So they're going to go for it here. Catch, first down, and he's knocked out.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
First and 10, ball on the 16-yard line. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Complete and taken down immediately.
That brings him second and five.
Quick strike to the receiver, and he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers. So that was a really good effort.
And this is the 12th play of the drive.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike the 59.
He gets rid of this one. It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out. Late in the fourth quarter, one possession game, and this is where poise really takes over. Whoever shows it will win the football game. Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he hits the PAT. So a 14-play, 62-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. Both these defensive coordinators have got to be going crazy right now. We've had four straight possessions in which these offenses have put points on the board. This is where the offense has to come to the forefront. They work all week for situations like this. They've got the lead, they've got a chance to add to it, and that'd mean a victory. Good outside run there. Taylor gains about 5 yards on the run. Arkansas is going to use their first time out of the half here. From the 36-yard line, it's second down. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He's at the 20, and he tackles him hard at the 13-yard line. The defense might have just run out of chances with that first down right there.
This offensive line definitely left it all on the field today.
They bring him down in the backfield.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
From the 16-yard line. The 10. Brought down at the 3.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. Third down.
Touchdown, Ragin' Cajuns. Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough.
Offense.
He makes the PAT. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
We've been watching this one going on in Manhattan. And for Kansas State, they've lost two in a row. Memphis grabs the W by a touchdown.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. Foster gets set to kick this one away. He'll return it from the 4-yard line.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
Nothing left here except to see the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening. Zips it to the tailback, incomplete.
Well, he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 21. Out of bounds, around the 27-yard line. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. In a game that had to be a defensive coordinator's worst nightmare, it's over. Louisiana Lafayette, 35, Arkansas, 25. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. From Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.